Hey everyone, my name is Doug Censor Martin.
My name is Asim.
I'm Benjamin Jack Bance.
And I'm the captain of Boston Breach Academy.
Challenger Call of Duty player for FaZe Black.
And I'm a professional Call of Duty player anymore. Oh, that's so depressing. That's so depressing, isn't it? What are you saying? I'm playing for Team War. Yeah? All right.
What is the Passion Pit? Back before the common use of online multiplayer, gamers would gather in a basement or someone's living room to determine the best player in the friend group. One day, the gatherings outgrew the houses. The competition and love of gaming spread like wildfire. Thousands of gamers traveled across the country or even across the world for their chance at being crowned the best. No salaries, no streams, just pure, unfiltered love for the game. That is the Passion Pit. For 8 years, the way the open bracket worked remained the same. Make it to the end of the open bracket and get seeded into the championship bracket to play against the pros. But in 2019, there was a shift. Pros and amateurs would be separated into two completely different brackets. Then, in 2020, competitive Call of Duty moved into a city-based franchise with permanent league spots, shifting the power from the player collectives and pro points to the owners of the spots. This, combined with the separation of brackets, is what many players believe to be the reason for a compounding divide between professional and amateur players.
So MW2 season ended with us not going to Champs, unfortunately. Again, the league decided to do an online qualifier for Champs. I can't understand it. The one team that made it was a team with a cheater on it, which is just hilarious to me.
Yeah. So you got cheated on. That you would have been here competing.
Oh, yeah.
That's bullshit, bro.
So this offseason was pretty tough because obviously last year for myself, Yuli, Nasty, and Scraps, we were on the London Royal Ravens, and suffice to say, it did not go well.
And that will do it here for the Ravens this season.
And we knew before going into this matchup, it was going to be very, very difficult for the Ravens to try to take down LA.
It was kind of tough for me personally. Like, I just felt like that was like one of my best years, like individually speaking. There was just a lot of dysfunction and I felt like I was in a very toxic environment and just an environment that like I don't think any of us could have prospered in. So it was just kind of like a self-sabotaging way for my stock and my career, I felt like.
The off-season for me, obviously I'm not going to go too in-depth because I don't want to call people out. People wouldn't believe how unfortunate I probably was with the teams. There was one team who said, yeah, you'll be receiving your contract within the next 24 hours. And then the next day got ghosted and they chose different players.
I mean, everyone in my ear was saying that, oh, don't worry, you don't have to be in Challengers, like one of these teams will pick you up. But then it kind of hit me by shock once the whole LAG fiasco drama came out.
Can't believe that happened. I've been pretty down bad.
I thought you guys were locked in.
Basically, they were going NA because they didn't want to pay visas, even though we said we'll pay our own visas and a bit of our own apartments.
So moving forward into the off season, we decided that we wanted to pick up Craze. Thought he was very disciplined, smart. He got top 8 at Toronto.
Mid to late July was when it was 100% I was probably going to be in Challengers.
I realized at the very last minute, 1 week into MW3, that I had to play Challengers.
The season ended in Vegas and everything felt great. You had grand finals of champs, main stage, 100,000 viewers on Twitch at the time. And then sort of nothing for 8 months. We knew it was going to be a crazy long off season. That wasn't like an unknown thing. We knew because of the way that the last season was scheduled and the game wasn't going to come out until November. We knew that we were in for a long wait. But when it just kept ticking over, then the rumors started to come around that Game Battles was going to be shut down. It caused so much anxiety for everyone because nobody knew where or when or how or for what we were going to be playing for in the amateur scene.
We all kind of had patience for them, but we were kind of like started to get frantic because
to know how this league works and to not get proper information on simple things like when is a tournament going to happen, how many tournaments are there going to be, why are we not playing anything for 2 months when the game comes out.
Players were starting to think like,
all right, what is going on? Like, can we get some news? Can we get some cups?
Is there even going to be a Challenger circuit this year? December came around. The first set of CDL matches were like that weekend. And we were like, okay, something needs to happen here for us to be able to just try and fill that gap.
The rotation hosted the first one,
which was NA and EU. We did completely separate tournaments, completely open bracket as well. The turnout was fantastic. The first NA Cup we did had 230 odd teams. The first EU Cup had 140 teams.
We got first in the first one, and we beat Temp and Co.
Let's go.
You guys are terrible. Bottom barrel, dog shit.
Fucking dog shit, brother.
Deviants threw 1K at the start.
And then Syndicate collabed with COD Asian to host the second.
Will. Secret.
The second one, we got third.
I can't even recall the feeling because it was just like an overwhelmed feeling of like, wow, we're actually doing something to help people.
Come on!
And then the third one that we competed in, we got first. The third one that we competed was the FaZe Black one. So it was pretty cool winning our own tournament.
Oh, let's go. Oh my god.
Oh my god, Asim just went too. That was big.
Oh my god.
They went well for us. I think we won both. We were looking pretty good in it. I think we may have won or lost one online tournament, but.
With Jay, I don't even know what our results were in those tournaments. Like, I don't even think we were winning series in top 16, top 24. But then we got Christian and we got fourth in the next tournament. So a lot of very inconsistent results, but.
Get a good one.
School spirit, alpha number.
Get in the speed.
Alpha step, omega step, kappa step, sigma step. Gangsters walk, pimps gon' talk. Ooh, hecky nah, that boy is raw.
Friday's three matches, and then Saturday is top 32 to top two. So that's gonna be like the long day. And then Sunday will just be the final.
I'ma get on this TV, mama. I'ma put this down. I'ma make sure these light skinned niggas never come back in style. Told them I finished school and I started my own business. They say, oh, you graduated. No, I decided I was finished. Chasing y'all dreams and what you got planned. Now I spit this song like a
So, how did you get here?
How did I get here on a plane? Honestly. How do I even answer that? What do you mean? Like my journey to this?
I leave it up to you to
remember how. Okay. How did I get here? A lot of time sitting in my bedroom, shouting at a TV. That's how I got here. In Black Ops 3 was my first open bracket, Anaheim. I was expecting something crazy. Obviously, when you were European and you went to American events, it was a big deal back then. And everyone was like, oh, be ready. This open bracket's gonna be a grind. It's gonna be tough. It wasn't, but it's nothing like back then anymore either. different. One, the competition. I feel like now the competition's harder. So I currently play with Nasty, who I think is one of the most underrated players to probably compete in the CDL. I've teamed with him before in Black Ops 4. He saved my career back then. I'm hoping he does it again this year.
All three of them, me and Sean picked up, they're incredibly talented.
Charlie Hicks, everyone knows what he's like. He came into the league last year, won his first event, champs runner-up. I don't think he could have probably done more in a season to be deserving of a spot. And then Ben Beans, everyone knows him. A lot of people hate him.
It is not realistic. You should not be able to do this.
The guy just brings crazy amounts of passion, and I genuinely believe he's one of the best talents to come out of Europe, and I'm hoping this year we can make people realize that as well. Hey guys, hey, come here. Just, if you want to say anything, just come sit close to me. Just, if you want to say anything, just come. If you just want to open up about anything, you know, if you want to have a heart to heart.
I love big booty Latinas.
Do you want to say anything to close me?
Oh my God.
What about you?
Oi, Ben, we got your present.
What is it?
We actually got you a quarter of a double stacked pancake. Yeah.
Yes, man.
It's good. Got, as well.
It's
good.
Is it?
Yeah, it's good stuff.
Nice, man. Yes.
We could eat it all because we had so much food.
Yeah, that's it. This is right. Branded. It's branded.
I brought them.
It's like 20 quid. That's what it is. It's quite nice. It's
very like.
No.
Oh, it's not possible.
Yeah, it's not. Does the job, you know?
They didn't like my performance last year.
So far, we walked to the Target, got some snacks, prepped for the major. Then we got some kava. Carson's never had kava before. Carson,
yep.
One out of 10 kava.
1 out of 10? 11.
11. You see? We're getting that every day.
Yeah.
Now we're about to scrim, play a warm-up scrim for the major. We're at Balance Patch. They're right next door to Boston University. So maybe we can get our education on afterwards. I don't know. Let's see. How did I end up here? Okay, so should I say like in gaming terms or like Boston, you think?
I wanted to leave the interpretation up to you, however you interpret that question.
Okay, how did I end up here? I ended up here because I stumbled upon Replays, also known as Crowder's Twitch channel.
I used to run subscriber tournaments towards the end of like every week.
And I was already a subscriber, so I just enrolled.
And he would just kind of play in them, and he was just like incredible. Like we would watch this guy play, and he would win like every single tournament, random teammate, by himself, it just did not matter. Whatever team he was on, he was winning. So we just kind of saw how skilled he was through that. And then
he just kind of winged me. He just helped me. He taught me the ropes. He taught me about competitive Call of Duty. And
he started, you know, meeting. He met JCap and Zuma and all these other pros like through me and like through the community.
I was just sending Crowder my amateur contracts because it was my first year competing. He knows like what contracts are bullshit and ones that are like okay. And I sent him 3 amateur contracts, and all of them he said were terrible. But then I was like, I understand they're terrible, but like I had to sign one because like I need to join a team. And then he said, no, like I won't let you sign this. So he actually talked to the FaZe, I think head of esports, and he helped fund the FaZe Black. So that's how FaZe Black originated.
Oh my God. Out of the way. There's a new FaZe hard carry right here, baby. If y'all don't know Asim, you're about to know real soon. Asim, 06.
I'm just showing off them.
Yeah, it was me, Simp, Celium, Phantoms, and Tom Gravity, and we actually won the first Challenger-only event. It was CWL Fort Worth in 2019 on Black Ops 4.
So they are now the hottest prospects for the Pro League, and teams should be hitting them up.
Winning that Challenger event and then instantly getting picked up on FaZe Clan and then being a pro for 4 to 5 years and now being in a Challengers-only event again, like, if we win again for FaZe Black and who knows, if we get picked up, it'll be just like a complete full circle. So it's been a lot of fun. It's been a lot of fun repping FaZe Black.
Nice, baby. See, Hagrid's doing pretty good, right?
Yeah.
2v4, 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 let's go 2v4. Bro, we're just setting up for my settings are so
fun. My teammates are awful, man.
Bro, I have a 2v1, 2v4. There's a setting on my game up where I walk on.
Minnesota's up 2-0. Damn! Red team!
Went great. 100 point club, everyone in every single map, so. It's great. Great practice.
You seem equal up towards the end of the game. Don't start speaking so far from our side.
The same defensive setup as well right now for a heritage. They have after the default, maybe a little bit more aggressive.
Now we play a very delicate game. They're not big a turtle, but they have everything covered. Kenny?
Operator, weapon blueprint, and so
how did you get here?
What do you mean by that?
However you think it means.
So I got here because I had to work really, 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 really hard, a lot harder than I ever had to in the past, that's for sure. It was never this hard back then. But now it's a lot harder. Not so much because of the competition. The competition's always been really good since day one in Call of Duty. It's a lot harder now because stigmas and stereotypes and players just not being able to prove themselves adequately. It seems that results aren't always the thing that truly matters anymore. So for me to be here and playing COD still, the results had to be consistent for a while. There had to be a lot of things that went right. And honestly, it's just a blessing to even play Call of Duty at 29 years old. I'm not sure why Slasher, Clay, the other guys my age, like never talk about these things, but I don't know, like the fight that I personally had to go through to like continue to play COD has been crazy. And I know I'm not the only one who feels that way. So. It's just a blessing to be able to play Call of Duty and almost turning 30. Like, I can't even believe it's real. I don't even know how I'm... Well, I know exactly why I'm sitting here right now, but... Man, when you get older, it's definitely harder. It's simply because people always doubt you because of the number associated with how long you've been on this world. Yeah, it's a lot. But we're here, and we're still here, and it's fun. So we're just going to enjoy every second of it while we have it.
So 9 days before an event,
we had the season one reloaded update.
Big update happens, and it's not just like, oh, they've nerfed a few guns or little things have changed, like a little one spawn point.
It's genuinely like we're playing an entire different game.
Oh my God.
Okay, so there's a lot.
This is the biggest update ever.
Everything has changed.
The spawns are different.
Hardpoint hills.
Guns have been nerfed and buffed, so.
You've spent 2 months scrimming the game, learning the ins and outs of where everything is and how everything works and where people will be spawning.
At first I thought maybe the pros helped, like saying this needs to get changed on maps. And then we were informed that was not true and the devs just thought, why not, we'll just end up changing everything. In, I think it was 3 days, we had the most important cup of our year.
So there wasn't an official stream. The league don't put streams on for cups. Two teams in particular, they refused to have somebody in the caster POV streaming the match.
This Boston Major being the biggest Challenger LAN, we didn't want any risk of like people stealing our strats or watching our gameplay.
And that caused some tension, I think is the best way to put it.
If he wants to keep tweeting out for clout and crybaby cheesing, he can. I don't care.
A lot of players saying we don't want anything to be shown in any form because they know how important this first match may be in terms of being an early, if not only, option towards getting picked up in the CDL, simply due to the fact that the only other confirmed event we have is in Toronto. And at that point through the year, we're already halfway through.
This will be the most important event because this is the only real event where players will be able to show themselves and get in the league from a LAN event.
The Challengers year, I feel, gets just more competitive over every single year. And there's basically like pro teams right now, you know, like
Hixie, Paul X, Gunless,
FaZe Black.
They've won basically every tournament I think they've competed in NA.
The individual plays you can watch Asim make on the map, he's just a good player.
Dave Patty, Yuli, and Two Real. I think those are three of some of the most underrated players.
Notorious guys, Harry, Wee Man, Steve-O, Mythix.
Bance's team, I think they're going to be a really top team and someone we're going to have to look out for deep into the tournament.
We have so many guys playing in Challengers right now who have proven it on LAN in the league, and yet here they are in Challengers. And
you could pick anybody from like the top 8 seeds and be like, yeah, they could improve one of the pro teams in some way.
I think this is the biggest Challenger event we have had in CDL history, if I'm not mistaken. So that's pretty exciting.
I would argue
outside of finals last year, this is probably the most important Challengers Open we've ever had when it comes to looking at Challengers as a whole.
The team is running on an all-time high and we're just super locked in and focused. And
what we want to do is win, straight up.
What I want to get out of this event is obviously a win. I don't see anything less than that.
Shot 5 bots, that's all I need to see. We're looking good.
Facebook on me, Facebook on 3!
You gotta fight for your right!
Facebook!
I'm just excited doing Wordle. Look how I'm so unlucky. Welcome back to Challengers, isn't it? Oh, I'm too old for this.
You gotta fight for your right.
Finally, bro.
These guys are blowing dunk balls.
Someone down the cut, let's run in.
Will now gather themselves just a small lead. 30-second shot for Gregg.
Map and Censor has been having a great last 2 to 3 minutes, picked up 4 or 5 kills. He's gonna find an answer one back there, and Censor continuing to fry.
Yo, I'm not gonna lie, that team is one of the most underrated amateur, like, we're all amateurs. But, like, I consider the Academy team, these guys are all CDL guys in a way. That team, I'm telling you, Chloe, Bowser, Gobla, and Zinx, that was one of the best, like, I know we're amps, but, like, I hate saying this about them because it's disrespectful. That was one of the best up-and-coming teams I've played on a LAN open bracket before. Like, map one wasn't easy. Map two, we were up 5-3 and we lost. We never lost that, ever. And then the control, like, we just iced it up, but, like, I don't expect that against a top team, not against a team like this. Like, I gotta tip it, they were good. We got Benjamin Beans next, tomorrow morning. That's gonna be the matchup of the century. Everyone's looking forward to it.
Yes, sir.
Got a lot of respect for those boys. Obviously, Ben was on Boston for champs. And I love the guys on that team. I've known them for a long time, so we should have a battle. It should be exciting.
Thank you.
Well, let's kick it off, baby. Day number two, Team War and Breach Academy. I mean, you couldn't ask for a better lineup here coming in towards this day. Hardpoint, Yeez now, trying to get something done himself. He's able to come up with one. A little bit of finessing from Yeez. I like what I'm seeing. And it will find Censor, so Nasty able to open up a bit of space. Pentagram turning and burning on Beads. Breach Academy might just be good for game number one. Spawns are deep.
Oh my fucking god!
Boston Breach Academy holds on, and they do, in fact, lock in map number one.
And on attacks, we just got to make sure if we get our first blood, we just play together and react. Like, we can rap bomb if we need to. We can do whatever the fuck we want.
It's been a great play of this. Look at the patience from Team War. I love that play!
Nice!
I think he got the hit marker, but he isn't going to challenge time.
Oh,
he's expecting a push, and Shine just sticks it! Destruction Man 2 from the back of the bridge. Beats, Delwyn, snaps all! He was looking for the second quickly with the pistol, wanted to catch Hixie off guard.
To keep Boston alive in the search and destroy, and he's not looking good for it, Austin. He's gonna get gunned down where he previously stood in Team War.
Come on!
Map number two.
Go, fucking
go. He's able to deal with Bance. We'll see if he can try to get
you
to the his Bean says no, snaps on his head, and takes him off the point. So not going to have any luck with the gun put on the Bean.
Oh,
he's still weak! And he finds another one on his sensor.
Oh, my God! Nine!
Simple shit on this fucking map, yeah? Okay, if we need to rotate, we rotate early. Make sure everything pushes together, yeah?
Now you gotta force a map five versus this Team War roster.
Breach have been so good at breaking it down, getting themselves in. They're in the point, looking for the back 25.
This setup is superb. Team War, still enough time here at D5 to close things out.
Seconds on the clock, you have to go, have to touch.
Oh my god!
Come on!
Come on!
I give you a map! I give you a map!
I'm gonna
run! Shit!
Fucking
running!
Sorry, I'm sorry.
The thing was, it's because of the third map you're fine, and then you start off the second map 3-0, and you were like, ah.
You went, Ben went, ah, oh, I can't stay down, I'm dead. Do you know where he was? He was laying down on the top blue crate of P5.
What?
No, he was laying down going, I can't stay down.
I don't have a trophy though, in the car, so I jumped on that to not get killed with the car.
No, I actually thought, oh no, we're gonna lose, when you died out of P2 there.
Yeah, no, that's what happened.
Hat to open.
Yeah, no, he slid across as you were shooting the guy in the back of the map.
Holy fuck, bro, I couldn't shoot straight.
This morning, well, at first we were like, we'll get there for half 10. Because they said starts at 9 a.m, but they got two loser games like to go. So we were thinking, all right, it's going to be about half 10, maybe a bit later, because of what happened on the Friday. And me and Ben went down 10 to 10 maybe to go Starbucks, waiting for these two to come back or come downstairs ready. You messaged me going, I'm at station one. I'm like, what the fuck? What do you mean you're at station one? I'm at the hotel. And then we would get spam call, like, yo, they called your game. So we're all sat there stressing. I ordered the Uber. Admins are going, yeah, if you're late by, 10:15, you get forfeited the map. So we're like, all right, fuck it, there's a good chance we forfeit the map. So we're doing the vetoes as well in the car. And then it changed from forfeiting the map to a whole series. And that's when everyone started stressing. And then pull up, I think at like 3 minutes, and sprinted, hopped out the Uber, sprinted in. Obviously security's a bit difficult, they obviously have to check us and that. Luckily someone from Boston came out and was like, yo, just get these in and I'll bring the bags in. Sat down, no warm up, lost first map, then on the next three. Stress, honestly. I'm sat there in the Uber, eat my food, down in my drink. So I need to get it down with quick and sprint. Never again, never again.
While you guys are in the free-for-all, just get the comms flowing. Like, that way we, like, communicate well, like, while we're playing, you know what I mean? It's always the morning matches where, like, we get caught off guard. So it's like, we gotta come out fucking strong.
Oh my god, don't spawn in! It's not safe! Right.
You guys fucking suck! Dog shit fucks! Top 4 in your own region. Dog shit ass region. Dog shit fucks. Oh my god, that's fucking embarrassing! That's fucking embarrassing!
Hey, look at me! Look at me! I always ran this page and I always will!
Oh, damn!
GG's, my guy. GG's, guys.
I run the Spanish.
Yeah. What's his name? Chaz? Chaz? What's his name? Has Chaz?
Doesn't matter. Crimpin' 3.
I played the drums, you roll the drums. Yo, Asim. You guys are delaying the bracket here. Come on, let's get things moving, yeah?
Bro, they told us an hour and a half. We're at the Shell or the gas station, and they're like, yo, your match is up.
Yeah.
Listen, for these next two respawns, like, we really need to be on our bullshit with the fundamentals. I know you guys will gun the fuck out of them, but it's like, can we do shit together to actually make shit work? We good?
Yeah.
Alright, let's go.
Alright. Come here, please, 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 please help. Oh my god.
Let's fucking go, Sam.
Four piece for the Dubski? Damn.
Alright, spawn out, spawn out. Two spawn back, one on time. We're good. Everyone regain. We got good maps now.
Maybe we don't have a bear.
Yeah. Stop. One shot, wheel. This one there, so. And one shot, bro. Listen, it's two B street.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, shit. GG, bro. GG, bro.
When you're home alone in the mood, I know you want to move.
We work really, really hard. We're really confident. We know our strengths and weaknesses very well. We know our competition strengths and weaknesses very well. We've done a great job on short notice preparing for this tournament.
Challengers to play. We've got Boston Breach Academy taking the stage yet again, trying to get back a loss from earlier. And we are just about ready to get underway. Loser will be done.
All right, come on, boys. Fucking into these.
Nowhere to go, nowhere to breathe, we know invasion is defense.
This is it, bro.
It could all come down to this round. Censor wants to get up close and personal.
No, it's once personal.
Censor doing anything he can to stay alive, stay kicking.
No play, weak, it's your right.
Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, tell me why are you still so afraid? Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. Hey, but you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you?
I knew that after this tournament was over, it was time for me to retire from Call of Duty as a player and move on to doing a lot of other things, such as breaking the Guinness World Record for most pull-ups in 24 hours, growing the Boston Breach in ways that I see fit.
I mean, honestly, the one thing that really made me know that Doug was a true friend of mine, he seemed more ecstatic than I was that I was becoming a pro. That, to me, hit really hard in the heart, that someone, like, genuinely did care so much. And I, quite frankly, don't know if I would have kept competing if I had to work and go to school and play at the same time. I don't think I would have been able to do it. But Doug opened up an avenue for me that I otherwise wouldn't have been able to take.
And you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want, or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, why don't you realize Vienna waits for you? When will you realize Vienna waits for you?
And I'm gonna say this to you, like, this gravity of what I'm feeling from all this training is fucking killing me, bro.
What?
It's killing me. Like, all this training.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I imagine.
Like, bro, but it's weird. Like, I've developed this, like, I don't even know how to describe what it is, but I could feel so much around me all the time. It's weird. But the second I play, like, I just went to Paradox's booth. The second I play, it's like I'm in a whole other world.
Yeah, you just
my focus is so much stronger than it's ever been.
You just said, no, hold this.
I feel like I could see every way we could win and lose at the same time. Like right now. It's fucking crazy.
Doug was by far probably the best teammate I've probably ever had.
I knew in this game he's going to be a beast too. I love teaming with Apathy. He's one of the best underrated players I've ever seen.
Easily was the best whenever it came to like out of game, believing in you, always gassing you up, making sure that his teammates around him were fully confident in their ability.
And one of the guys outgunned me and he started screaming, "Censor, you're washed." And in my head, just something clicked.
I knew that if I was going to do this, I was going to go all in with it, and I was going to take it 110%.
We had to get a pickup for it, and ever since then, we've been fighting our way to get our name back up there to the top. Because we feel we can do this. We feel we can win the event. And it's finally paying off. I feel on top of the world right now. It's an amazing feeling. This is what I've been working for years. This is my passion. This is my dream. I want to win. I want to be number one.
Ladies
and gentlemen!
How long do you plan on being an MLG pro? That's actually a really good question. How long do you plan on doing this, being a professional gamer?
I really don't plan it. I want to make a career out of it if I could. I'm just going day by day with it and seeing what MLG wants to do with the competitive scene. So.
Well, Doug, you can't always be number one. And with that, he stopped me short. He goes, someone's got to be number one, and it's going to be me. And I was like, oh, okay. And within 1 month, he was number one. Very determined, you know. He does. He beats all the odds. And we are very proud of him.
Cool. Perfect. Thank you, sir.
Sweet.
Appreciate it.
He was talking about the bracket, and that reminded me of Ant.
And
And we're going to keep them on stream here up against their next winner's round opponent. That's going to be FaZe Black.
Subbase will be first on the docket. Obviously, we are into the winner's side of the bracket. FaZe Black, obviously, we talked about lots of ex-pro players, lots of CCL veterans in this lobby, lots of tenured Call of Duty players that are trying to get to that sweet, sweet top spot.
Three down for FaZe, looking to find the last one. Krempy will fall. Pro Loot's got two. All of FaZe Black falls. He will find a double kill. Make that a three-piece for Dylan Rex. Asim will find one back. Houston does lose control of the point, but they have continued to grow this lead, and they're going to start to get these rotations ready, and they are looking locked and loaded for it. But it looks like the Houston Spartans, barring a last-second play out of FaZe Black, will walk away. Map one victory from FaZe Black. FaZe Black looking to battle back in this map two, Terminal, Search, and Destroy.
Houston Spartans looking unstoppable today.
Well,
but wait a second, Exceed answers back with two. Can he find it? Oh my lord.
Time!
Look at the time. Oh! Look at his health though. FaZe Black!
Wait, last get top AC. Last get top 3 AC.
Nice.
Pick up that so you don't
let's go huddle up again real quick.
We gotta turn up a little bit. I feel like they're playing with a lot more like passion than we are. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like let's actually fire ourselves up a little bit and fucking lock
Yeah, don't
it.
Fucking scream, but yo, bring up the
also,
energy.
Also, yo, in the cup, we were all preening, we were waiting for Pro and Dylan Rex. And I feel like
bro,
now we're, like I'm running at them, we're all running at them. Let's just like let's seriously hold our irons.
Yeah.
They will run into us, bro.
Two slow players, two fast
it's
players.
It's just like the first match against the Spanish people. If we just gun up, they will run into us.
One thing I love, like, yeah, we were getting clutched on a lot, whatever, but the composure.
Yes, the composure was there.
The composure to make the comeback was amazing, but now we gotta lock in. We can't fuck around.
No, 100%.
Let's play with anger. Bro, we're not losing.
Fuck this cool comment. Like, there's no screaming, but bring up the fucking energy, bro. Sorry about that. Talk about
it. Let's go. We want to beat these guys so fucking bad. Let's go. Let's fucking act like it. Let's go.
Come on. Both of these squads, they want to get to the end of this bracket. They want to crown themselves as those major one champions. But we've still got three maps left in this series. And now it's going to be Control to see who will take the lead.
Forget about it. FaZe is crying right now.
Yeah, that is, I think, 9 unanswered kills as the kill feed looks like. You see, everybody is on a streak right now.
I need to point. Top left.
Oh my god! Now all you have to do is win your ones, and that's it! Oh my lord, Exceed! Oh my god!
You guys fucking suck! Jesus Christ! Bro, Luke, look at me!
Shit.
You are fucking dog shit! That's right, don't look at me, you dog shit fuck!
Oh my god, you guys might be the iciest team of all time.
We're gonna see if Houston is at the best they got, because it's now or never. FaZe is up 100 plus points. Nobody can contest this man. Not even Dylan Rex. A Sim's there to help with a two-piece. FaZe Black.
You guys fucking suck! You fucking suck! Why'd you do it? You
fucking
suck. You have a
0.4
in the league.
Fucking awful. Don't talk to me. You got shit on. You fucking suck.
GG, bro.
For sure, guys.
You're so bad.
I ran a full time sub that whole map.
Yeah. That's on the auto heal, too.
Get her, Lois. Come on, baby.
Robin?
So let's go.
No one's gonna kill him, too. Get the fuck out. That's boring as hell.
Wow, that was a great series. I had a lot of fun. Yes, sir.
All right, guys, lobby up on Cruz.
This guy loves hosting on LAN and online. Nothing.
Welcome back, all you beautiful people. We are live. Winners finals. We're jumping right into it. FaZe Black up against SGP. It is going to be a banger. Whoever wins this moves on to the main stage tomorrow to potentially win it all. He's going to make his move.
Oh, the pixel peak. Nice shots.
Clean.
Coming through from Caden's AR. So that'll be the last 10 seconds. Soaked up for SGP. They'll have themselves just narrowly a 20-point lead going in towards the second set. Lunars, he's got himself a nice little spree going, gonna be able to accrue himself a cruise missile, and they're quite comfortable with this setup. If you ask me, Austin, they have hotel set up, they get the majority of time on P1, and they have a cruise missile for the break.
Gunzi, who doesn't manage to find the kill, Lunars now up to 7. Can he make it 8? I thought his teammate maybe finish him off, and oh, crap!
Only plus 1 as far as KD is concerned, but 29 engagements is a very good spot to be at an SMG of his pace. Even challenge backside of bus stop, Exceed. just eviscerated him. Over 200 points, FaZe Black need to hold this hill.
Oh, Krem. He'd be red on this little bit of a pinch. Oh, we gotta win those crews.
To say that you need to play damn near flawlessly is putting it lightly.
New hill will pop, 214 to 246. SGP just need 4 seconds for the dub. Lots of other players taking routes here for SGP. Just need to find one good break. Eric is into the point.
In.
Someone has to contest. Eric for two. Who is it gonna be? Can Exceed go big? He's got assistance from Brack on the outskirts, but is it enough? Exceed finds another. Looking to the pistol.
Oh my God.
Challenges out. Exceed keeps the game alive. We are going to one more hill. It's a 2v3 across the map. FaZe Black are not out of it. Just yet, Andy.
Cruz, he spawns all the way out, hits a 2v2 for the new hardpoint, and FaZe Black actually come out on top. They're getting the kills on the backside of Market, no entrance for free, and FaZe Black!
Oh, oh my God! God! You guys both, oh my God, you guys suck dicks. This is insane.
We will be jumping back in. We'll be the attacking side, SGP.
SGP, winning a few rounds in a row. Don't let these boys cook.
That's so unfortunate, bro.
All down to Krep. 1v2. Can he make it happen? That's the first. Challenges for the second. And Eric's got no time to work with. Krep is sending us to a round 11. Can the kid do it? Has to go for a bomb check. Bomb is good. Both players, though, going to be collapsing from either side. Exceed on the stairs. Will win the battle.
Nice. Let's fucking go.
And there is the victory. Big control win. Enough to at least see one more map as we'll head to that Skid Row.
Skid Row hardpoint. That first hardpoint, if you're just now joining us, it ended in a photo finish. Just 3 points in between these two teams. And with that kill on the Gunzi, that will be it. They're going to concede the space, set themselves up over towards P5. 14 seconds are all that SGP need to force a map number 5 onto Terminal. But FaZe Black, one good break, and they'll call game.
No, go shot. You got top B2. Car hop, Gunsy, weak. Someone go top shot and challenge it. Top right, Cree, dead! One was top B2. Back left, dead. Yes, I'm trying to hold it, bro.
Close, dead. One more. Tunnel, one shot.
Pinch, dead.
One shot.
Who are you?
How do you choke that? You guys are awful!
Eric,
you guys are fucking awful!
Eric, I love you, but Basuna! Basuna!
Let's go.
Fucking shit, bro.
Fucking
finals, bro.
Finals, bro.
Fuck this guy. Caden spilled his Red Bull, bro.
Hey, Tommy.
Yo, what's up, Angel?
What's up, man?
Yeah, that's a big win, bro.
It's a big, big win, yep.
Yeah, I'm talking about.
We just packed up, and we're about to head out.
All right, man. Yo, Asim, give everybody my best over there. Show everybody some love, man. Hey, good job. All right, I'm proud of you guys.
Thank you, Tom.
Good luck tomorrow, man. We'll be tuning in, bro. Love
Thank you, bro. I love y'all. See you tomorrow.
Later, bro. Peace.
Yeah, let's go, guys. We won 9 rounds of winner bracket. We're in the grand finals now. So, you know, as you all know, you guys are covering the 3 challenger players. I'm the last one standing. Hopefully, we come out with the dub. And, yeah, win the Boston Open Major. Let's go. No, yeah. You know what they say? I'm number what? I'm number one.
Snowy Fenway here in Boston, and oh, we've got yourself a real hot start to Championship Sunday. For the first time in the regular season, we've got Challengers Grand Finals on the main stage. Oh, this is gonna be a fun one. We've got some known names on one side and some unknown names on the other.
It feels so good. I feel like I can barely even see you anymore, Alan. But yeah, Challengers back on the main stage here in Boston. We are slated to have a fantastic time. As you were already talking about, this FaZe Black roster, all 4 of those players, you have seen them in the league just this past season, but across the stage, some names some people might not know.
When
we start off the day, I do think we need a little like boost upper type of thing, because I think we're gonna come into mellow and these kids are gonna come in hot no matter who we play.
Yeah.
And like that first map, like we always make that adjustment afterwards, but we should make it before going for the map.
Right? Yeah, like our first map has to be like our best map.
Yeah.
That shit is gonna be the hardest map in the fucking series.
Yes, exactly.
You know what I mean? Right now, I could, like, bro, if you walk up the staircase, you literally hear them fucking screaming.
Brack, Seed, Crep, Exceed, all of which were in the league last year, if not further beyond that. The thing about it is, we had teams like Team War that came out, full EU roster of former CDL players that only finished top 12. So it's been really strange because I think looking at a glimpse, we're saying that the rosters of veterans, we're going to be able to handle the change maybe a bit better, but that hasn't been the case, save for this FaZe Clan Black team. They've looked good through the cup and this weekend.
And what honestly can't you say about Asim at this point? Ever since he's kind of came into the scene, he's always had a name for himself. Very explosive player, very veteran instincts coming through as well. All four of these players are an accumulation of just how good the Challenger circuit can truly be.
I know what it takes to win. Like, I've won before in the biggest leagues, and I just need to build myself back up. And I mean, in the last four Challenger tournaments, we kind of just won the last three out of the four. So I feel like if I keep at this pace, like, I can definitely see myself coming back after last year's performance.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Sorry, all right, let's go, Jess, come on. Map one, baby, come on.
The Challengers on main stage.
Nice three. We're missing one. Missing one. Nice. That's the first guy.
A moment like this to showcase what you're able to do underneath the bright lights. Time to at least find more kills. The first 40 seconds has been good. And Crep snaps on a whiz up top of the stairs.
Point, so a very clean opening map one for FaZe Black. We're into the terminal search and destroy.
It's already starting. Fucking up.
Okay. Geoglow Frosty stuck just against the scene. Looking for the wall banks, not able to convert. Stun out, finds the first scene. Do they get the 1v1?
Die!
Sure, finds it a 1v2. There is not a lot of opportunity for Lore to escape this point.
No.
Nice! Let's go! Come on, baby. Come on.
And decisive round coming through for FaZe.
No, my fucking god! Go, baby. Come on. Kidding. Let's fucking go. You like that comm, baby? You like that comm? Come on, baby.
The way they're playing, they're so shook.
But yeah, our comms are really good. I feel like for invasion control though, like on our offenses, the only trouble we've had was killing that guy AS&D. We've got to like take our time with that gunfight, like while we're going around and while like reflanking.
Also,
from
on the defensive breaks, you guys need to work together on like that guy A Street, so I can go mid, okay?
Yeah.
So like, make sure you guys use your tacks, like your stun, on the dumpster and the mid tank.
Yeah, for that. Like, right? Let's go on stage. I'll talk on stage. Go. No, yeah, you guys are reading everything. We're communicating on what we're holding. We're doing everything right. We gotta just like keep it up, keep being consistent. I feel like you guys honestly like got this shit in the bag, man. We're good? All right, let's fucking go, boys. Let's do our thing.
My head in the couch, my feet on the ground.
Don't sleep on the fact that this FaZe Black squad can also bring some electricity as we jump into our invasion control. You're absolutely right, the FaZe Black defense. Just too strong of a start. BB worked on. Exceed. Oh, impressive kill onto Craig.
Now just 10 seconds remain. FaZe Black nowhere to be found.
Here we go. Lore Gaming set themselves up at the last moment.
Not even going to make this shit complicated. Play good spots. Play your ones. Fucking simple. Keep the energy up. Let's fucking shit on these guys. Let's play our game.
Towards AC. So FaZe read the response, and they put themselves in a great setup here on Zoom.
And a long haul.
Crep has looked really, really solid with a sub here today. Low Frosty for the first, down low. Geo trying to take it off angle, but the kills continue to go back and forth, and it's a seam. Oh, I'm telling you, this guy gets in the mix, and he thrives in it.
There we go. There we go.
Let's fucking go, man.
One map away from claiming their prize. That's
Don't let them, just don't let them do that brain dead shit. They're not gonna play for plants, they're playing for kills. One fucking more map, bro.
And it's,
shit's ours.
Remember, on offense, we can make teams rap. Like, we could always smoke.
Invasion will be the locale for us, and for FaZe Black, they are one away from living out what they were built to do, win a championship early on in this season. Silence echoes over Invasion to this point.
A
Let's go, boys.
We don't wait the map, just like online, baby. That was beautiful.
Rappy.
2v2, here comes the pinch though from Brack. 1v1 with Wiz. Wins the first one. Now to the pistol.
Yeah! Let's go! Let's go, boys. Come on!
He's the play, Girl Frosty to check. The shots almost land, but talking about a bit of an issue. We've got ourselves around 11. 1v3. But it slipped away. First one's going to be free. Exceed backs up over towards ice cream. Actually, he's going to play on tractor. Geo surely checks this.
I still don't think he's going to down. Shot. Exceed's not
full HP. He knows he's going to die. Let's fucking go! Yeah, my name.
I know way too many people here right now. Who the fuck are y'all? I swear it feels like the last few nights. We've been everywhere and back, but I just can't remember it all. What am I doing? What am I doing? Oh yeah, that's right. I'm doing me. I'm living life right now, man. And this is what I'ma do till it's over. Till it's over.
Three lands in a row, baby. That's a 3-peat.
Let me talk to you, man.
The love is real right now.
It
Let's
really
go.
Is.
I had a lot of L's last year. Obviously, it was a really tough year, but I'm glad we came up with the dub.
But it just feels good to be back after so long and just win. It feels great to win, to be honest. I think when it comes to winning this Challenger event, it just honestly makes me way hungrier to get back in the league, because I know what it takes to win, and I've done it on the biggest stage, just like today. But it just makes me hungry just to get back with the CDL and become a professional again, because I truly don't feel like I belong here in Challengers, and I'm glad I showed it this weekend.
All right, I think we're good.
Wait, hold on.
We apologize for interrupting your program for this special news bulletin. The Call of Duty 2 PC League, with televised finals and a £1,000 prize. Only on xleague.tv.
We did some research. We saw these kids are having tournaments, and there's stuff happening over in Korea. We didn't think that would play here. So like, how do we bring that to the States? How do we bring that to North America?
I think one of the first kind of real experiences I saw of passion across the table was very much a competition called XL5.
In the Call of Duty 4 5v5 Search and Destroy tournament, over 20 teams would be vying for the championship.
That was when I really saw the kind of the potential for esports and the potential for, you know, the passion between two sets of teams, because,
yeah, this is the main stage.
People were just screaming back and forth at each other. Back then, it was kind of, there wasn't really any rules about what you could say either. Back in the day, going to all these early COD events, it was just, you could tell it was so much passion.
Now you can see they're very intense into the game.
It is what esports is about, is about people competing against each other.
Yeah, I do think like it's gonna be really sad. Like, I know before this event we had some offers that we might have turned down to some CDL teams, just because we really wanted to focus on winning this event and seeing who else would be looking to make a change. So it'll definitely be sad if one or two or the whole team goes, because we're not gonna be the same team that we won from before.
Feel like for me personally was good. I got married, I've got a dog, house, so my personal life is skyrocketed and I couldn't be happier.
You used to have those open bracket teams mixing with the pro teams. How do you know how good a player is if he hasn't been had a chance to play against the best people?
And we should make it an incentive-based thing where if you get a great result on LAN, you have a better opportunity of getting into the league.
I definitely have more respect for Challengers.
I think these kids are good. I thought they were really bad.
My whole life is thanks to competing against other people online and for people setting up these tournaments. And yeah, it's crazy that it's got here.
Don't get me wrong, obviously, the CDL without the pro teams wouldn't be a league, but without challengers, without the fans, without the grassroots, there's nothing.
It's the root of everything, you know, like that's where everyone comes up, that's where they start playing. And
you have to have tier two in order to feed into the top leagues, because where are you going to get your talent from otherwise? And I think that's what's probably really hurt Call of Duty Esports, is the fact that the CDL kind of discredited tier two in a way.
There's not really many opportunities for players to prove themselves, and that's the thing that kind of makes it disheartening for me.
I feel like our main reason why Call of Duty competitive is so like interactive and fun is through the events, and when you don't have a lot of events through the year, people start to not only miss it, but they start to forget the feeling and the vibes that you get from a Call of Duty event.
I just like the environment, dude, hanging out with some good old gamer buddies.
Here we go, months not seeing these guys, and you come out here to an event where competition is high, and it's definitely a good time.
The experience is, it's more than the game at this point. For me, Call of Duty is about the people here, the community. They're awesome.
Oh! Yo! Yo!
What? We should always promote people to go out to LANs. We should always promote people to be their best selves.
You know, anytime you go to an event and you see the passion pit, those people have paid to be there. Those people are on sponsorships. So the people that are there, they're there because they absolutely love COD. They want to compete against other people. And I think you get to really see that, and that's why it ends up being such a fraught and angry environment, because, you know, these people have put everything on the line. But then when you meet up with these people that you've been in all these calls with, all these chats with, it always seems very normal. All these people wouldn't be friends with each other, because, you know, you've got the jocks, you've got the nerds, you've got the whole, like, all the different, everyone's equal, because it doesn't matter about how tall you are, how strong you are. All that matters to these people is how good you are in the game.